So right now, it's almost 8 o'clock and we were gonna wake up early this morning to beat the heat, but there's not a lot of heat to beat. It's wet and cold and feels a little like the Appalachian Trail actually. You can see all the fog behind me. Not that I've done the Appalachian Trail, but this is what I feel like it would be like. Just everything drenched. Once you take one step, your feet are immediately soaked. Your tent is wet, so it's all on the outside of my pack this morning. Yeah, super fun stuff. I needed to start moving, but the guys are back at camp still because they had a slower morning than I did. But once I get out of the tent, I'm going because I get cold. But in exciting news, in 10 to 11 miles, I'm going to hit the 500 mile mark. What? So I'm super excited for that. Got the Proclaimers I Would Walk 500 Miles downloaded, so I'm ready. It's cold and it's wet and it's windy, but I just hit 500 miles. I'm a little excited. Very excited. I still have all my rain gear on. Stylish! 500 miles. That's insane. I can't believe it. That's crazy. Look at it. But it's written in stone, so it must be true. Over there is just desert and windmills, and here is a dense cloud and lush forest. To celebrate going 500 miles north of Mexico, I'm eating a peanut butter chocolate chip complete cookie, my new favorite flavor. So good. This is a good moment. Very happy. Really can't believe that I've hiked 500 miles. It kind of blows my mind. It's a lot of miles. I still have a few more to go though, so we'll see how those go.
They may be screaming at us.
They're pine nuts from
they'll be involved.
Gray pine tree. Sure. I mean, that's what it's called. Gray pine is a species. And so we scavenged these nuts from the pine cones that have been laying on the ground all winter. So they're mostly empty. But we harvested this whole pile right here and only got that tiny little pile of good nuts.
How long did it take?
However, each one is super delicious. So
those are the good nuts.
Yeah.
And it took you like over an hour?
Which part?
Cracking and harvesting.
It wasn't like he had nothing else to do though.
Probably 3 hours.
I've been doing this all afternoon.
True. Worked it.
Yeah, those are. Yep.
Nice.
And we're gonna make a special little
pesto.
Yes, a little thing. Well, no, but I don't call it whatever you want, but.
Interesting. Just had a nice little rattlesnake encounter.
No.
Now we're walking to Hiker Town.
A little too close to that.
Alright, so we made it to Hiker Town. And Aaron and Christoph are taking that cabin. And this is my humble abode. I'm staying in the doctor's office. Little nightstand and a little couch. Very nice. All right, so it's 5:30 in the morning. I got up at 4 a.m. and I am hiking on bam! It's gorgeous. For some reason, this moment is one that I pictured before I left for the trip. I read up on some LA aqueduct facts. And so just being here is very surreal to me because I've seen so many pictures of people hiking on the aqueduct and was excited for this moment, and now it's here and it's happening and I'm so happy. Yeah. And the sun is rising. Let me show you. So here's the aqueduct. Straight, straight, straight. There's the sunrise. So today started out great. It started with the sunrise and the aqueduct and the Joshua trees, which was gorgeous. And I listened to U2's Joshua Tree album while I walked through the Joshua trees. Highly recommend. And then I saw a bunch of butterflies, a bunch of lizards, two snakes. One was dead and getting eaten by ants. And the other one was a 4 foot long sand covered or sand-colored snake that just crawled right across the trail. But honestly, the hiking trail today has been pretty brutal. It's just hiking along a dirt road, so it's not very nice on the feet, even though it's flat. And it's definitely heated up, but I just ran into a super nice couple who yelled out, "Do you need anything?" I'm like, "I think I'm okay." And they're like, "Do you want a cup of ice water?" And I'm like, "Okay." So they gave me ice water, which was amazing. Honestly, it's the little things in life. And they were so cool. They are from California and they come out here to ride their motorbikes. And they also take their trailer when they want to go surfing on the beach. But they were just a great couple, and I love meeting good-hearted people. So today I've hiked a total of 27 miles, my longest day so far. I'm camping down there. Yeah, I feel alright. My feet could be better, but your feet pretty much hurt every day when you're out here. So, not too shabby. Officially walked a marathon. Good job, legs. This amazing little lounge in the middle of the desert with drinks and trash cans and chairs. Oh my gosh, this is amazing. This is honestly probably the nicest thing I've seen on trail yet. Just a bunch of chairs and an umbrella and trash cans and water and hot sauce and ketchup and forks and all in the middle of the desert on top of this hill after climbing like 1700 feet. So it's perfect. Thank you to whoever put this here. Oh, so grateful for you. Another gorgeous day on the trail. There's yellow flowers and lupine and all these things flying everywhere are butterflies, and then windmills over there. I feel pretty good today, actually, despite hiking 27 miles yesterday. But I think that's because the terrain was pretty easy. It was hard on the feet because of the hard surfaces, but there wasn't much elevation gain. So that was good. And I'm about, I don't actually know, maybe 6 miles from the road into Tehachapi right now. So I will be there soon, which is very exciting. And I'll probably stay at least one night, if not two nights.
Dark chocolate.
Do you dress it up yourself? Oh, okay.
Yeah, it doesn't play around. Just gonna cram it in there.
Yeah.
Do you want to put it in my bag?
Goosefoot.
It's good.
That's good training.
It's doing its thing.
You gonna make a salad later?
No.
No.
Cook it.
Okay.
Yeah, like spinach. Cooked spinach. Like same things.
Saute.
Yeah, saute. Some of that famous olive oil.
Nice.
Pretty
delicious.
Good.
She has a jacuzzi there, and this is her backyard view. Tehachapi.
What's she doing there?
We are making banana bread. My favorite thing ever. Well, muffins, and then a square dish, because there's no loaf pan. Beautiful. And then beans for our jumbo burritos. It's pretty exciting.
How are you liking it?
Oh my god, it's amazing. We're staying at Brenda's house. She's a trail angel and she's the nicest lady in the whole entire world. Yeah, she's just like letting us use her kitchen. It's pretty cool. It's a pretty nice house. Do you like it?
It's lovely.
It's lovely.
Nice.
Have a vlog. Alright guys, what do we got going on?
Cinco de Mayo!
Hey. So, we're having Mexican food. Here we have beans. What kind of beans are these?
Pinto beans.
Pinto beans. And here?
Pinto beans.
With?
With olive oil and a chopped up mushrooms and onions and garlic.
Broccoli and onion.
Broccoli and onions and olive oil.
Banana bread. That's afterwards.
Mm.
And what else? What are these?
Those are wild greens from PCT, basically, that we picked today.
So good. What's the plant called, though?
It's called, it goes by many names. I kind of like goosefoot myself.
Goosefoot? Yeah, that's your name to yourself.
Carrots,
onion, chips.
We got the guac.
The guac.
There's gotta be more too.
You gotta label your food. So
yeah.
There's pineapple salsa. And sweet potatoes! And tortillas. Oh wait. Gotta show the jumbo tortillas.
Jumbo.
Hold these up for comparison. Oh yeah, so they're bigger than his face.
Oh yeah.
There you go.
There you go.
Very nice. You guys excited?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you excited?
Definitely excited.
A little bit.
I wasn't that much more than me. Yeah.